You want to create a new condition record, but the field combination you need is not available. Have you seen my last video? I have explained the complete vendor consignment process. Check it out. Also, if you like this video, please subscribe, share, and turn on notifications so you will not miss any of this video again.
The condition technique is widely used in SAP, not only in material management, but also in other modules. It is used mainly for pricing, but it's also used in outputs. These are the elements that are involved in this technique. Some of them have the same name in pricing as well as in outputs, but in some cases, some of them are slightly different. For example, here we have condition types is the name for pricing, but when we talk about outputs, they are referred as message types. The message types refers to different kind of messages. For example, like a PO that we want to send to a vendor, or order acknowledgement, or expeditors. In pricing, the condition types can be referred to different kind of discounts or surcharges. Then we have the accept sequence. This is the same name in both cases. We can define it like the search strategy by means on which the SAP system search for valid message records. Then we have condition tables, and we can define it like the combination of fields for which you want to create a message record. In the center, we have the procedure, as it's called in pricing, or the message schema in outputs, but it contains all the allowed message types or condition types for each message application. And finally, we have the condition record, and this is defined how the system stores the specific condition for each message type or condition type. It is time now to jump into the system. I'm going to show this technique using the output and messages, but the same can be replicated for conditions, for pricing. So let's suppose that we want to create a new condition record to determine a PO output using some kind of combinations of fields. So for that, we go logistic, material management, purchasing, master data, messages, purchase order, and let's say we want to create a new condition record for an output type. In this case, the standard is new in SAP, but it is advisable that you don't change that one and you create your own. So in this case, I have created already the set new, and we will see the customizing. So here we see which combinations are available. We have purchasing organization and vendor for EDI, and we have another for document type, purchasing org vendor, and the last one with document type. Let's suppose that none of these three matches our requirements, and we need to create a new one with a different combination. So in my example, I'm going to add a new entry here using company codes. I see it is not used already. Okay. So let's go into the system, to the customizing. Material management, purchasing. And we have messages, output control, and here we have all our elements, the tables, the accept sequence, the message types, and the determination schemas. Okay. Let's take a look first at the message type that we are going to use. In our case, our method new is the standard one, but we have created a new one, set new, that it's a copy of the standard one. Let's go back. And here you have the fine tune here for your message type. You want to say if this can be determined at the time of the creation of the PO, it will be like option one, new, or when the PO is changed, it will be option two. So in our case, our set new is determined at the moment of PO creation and also at the moment of PO changes, if a relevant field is changed. Okay, this is our message type. And here we have our determination schema for POs. Under this one, we have our message type set new already included here. And this FB1. Yeah, it is here, and if we go back, we have the assignment of the same schema to our application EF, that is purchase order. This is a standard. Okay, now let's go to our requirement. Okay, we need to create first a new condition table for POs. So we're going to create a new one. Here we need to check if the number is not already taken. Yeah. We are able to use from 501 to 999. Okay, so we can use 990, or we can start from scratch or using another table as a copy, as a source. /986, for example. /987. Okay, here we have purchasing organization. So let's add company code. We can also add purchasing document type. Okay, here we have three fields. So now we want to generate a table. Okay. Here we have the log, table activated, generated object, and here we have our table, 990. Okay, now that we have our table created, we have to create an access sequence for purchase order. We're going to use the first one, and we can see the accesses that we have at the moment. Okay. So we want to include a new entry, 10 with 990. Okay. We are using the same requirement and standard, and we are checking the flag exclusive. This exclusive flux means that once a condition record is determined at one level, then it stops and it does not go on looking for the other tables. Here we can see which fields. Are assigned, which is organization, company code, and document type. This will be a workbench request, not a customizing request. Okay, so now we create our table and our access sequence for our message type. So now we are in a position to create a condition record. MN04, as we shown before, set new, and now you see that we have our new entry. Purchase organization, company code, and document type. So now we have to fulfill the values. Purchase organization 1000, company code 1000, document type MB. Set up the printer. Okay, now the condition record is saved. And now let's go and see if when we create a PO, this one is determined or not. So I'm going to use vendor this one, purchasing or company code, okay, and let's go to messages, and here we have our set new that is determined, and let's go and check based on which key it was determined. So here we have, and we can see that it's using which is organization, company code, and document type. Here you can see the technical names. Okay, so this is how you can create a new condition record for a combination of fields that do not exist previously in the system. So basically, you will have to create the tables and the async sequence and then make the link in the message type.
Have you created a condition table before? If so, in which application? Let me know in the comment below.
Okay, now we can also check tables that are used here. This is the table that we just created, right? And we see that we already have one condition record that was created for this based on this table. So that condition record can be seen in NACH table. Here you see all the details about that condition record. And then, as we've shown before, if we want to see the outputs that are determined in the POs, let's see what was the PO number we just created. This one. Application is EF for purchasing, and the object key is our PO number. And here you have in NASD table our PO. Status 1, that means it is a process, Okay, this output was already processed. Okay, this was for messages, but as we mentioned, the same thing is used in pricing. So if we want to take a look under the conditions, we have defined prices, price determination process. And here you will have the point to define your ASIC sequence, to define your condition types, your schema, schema determinations, and your table. Okay, so it is basically the same procedure. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time. Bye.
If you enjoyed this video, please give me a like, share, subscribe, and turn on notifications. Also, let me know in the comments below which other topics would you like to be included in this series. Bye.